Like what we're doing? Support us on Patreon.
Hey everybody, and welcome to another edition of Lane Side Reviews. And on this episode, we're going to be looking at 900 Globals After Dark Pearl. Guys, so welcome back. As always, I'm the Bearded Beast, Rob Johnson, joined once again by Scoops Porter, and as we said, we're looking at 900 Globals After Dark Pearl. So, this ball isn't quite a booyah, but not quite a boost. So, tell us about the ball, Scoops, and tell them why this is an important piece in 900 Globals lineup.
Well, it has the S30 Pearl cover stock.
Okay.
And it has the new Nightfall Symmetric High RG Low Differential Cord.
High RG Low Differential. Now, we see a lot of low RG Low Differential balls.
Yeah.
What does this High RG Low Differential combination create?
It creates good control.
Okay.
Amazing length.
Okay.
And outstanding performance.
Okay.
It gives like a medium to low flare. And it gets down the lane so smooth.
Okay.
And when it gets down there, it doesn't turn on a dime, though. It's got a very controlled back end.
Yeah. Now, for those of you who like core science, we know that high RG balls tend to be harder to get them to spin up. So this ball is definitely going to get down lane. And because of it being low differential, it's not going to have a lot of flare. It's not going to really read the end of the pattern hard. And I think we see that a lot in the video. And speaking of the video, why don't we take a look how this ball stacked up. Alright guys, here is Wayne Porter, our speed dominant player.
He's born on the DEFY house shot.
Now, we talked about in the opening on this, that this is a bit of a different ball. It's a high RG... low differential ball.
Yeah.
Now, we've seen a lot of low RG, low differential balls that are designed to read the mid lane but not really hook down lane.
Yeah.
And this is a much different concept.
Yeah. And you can watch it. It, like we talked about, it's very clean up front.
Yep.
But it doesn't spin up crazy down lane.
Now, for you technical guys out there, we talked a little bit about it. When you have a high RG ball, higher RG balls have weight farther away from the core.
Yeah.
So they are harder to rev up,
mm-hmm.
and they tend to lose their revolutions with more difficulty.
Okay.
So when you usually see a high RG ball, it tends to go down the lane farther.
Yeah.
And then when you have a high differential, it is very snappy off the end of the pattern.
Honey Badger. Prime.
Great example.
Yeah. Which is a great ball.
This one is a low differential. So when it reads... at the break point there, when it spins up, and you can see Wayne here at lane level, you can see that that ball doesn't really...
It doesn't do the bzzz.
Yeah,
thing
it doesn't spin
it,
up.
Yeah.
You get your what we call the pin to spin line, where the axis migrates across it.
Yeah.
It doesn't really do it that fast.
Yeah.
So for guys like yourself, high rev players, low speed players who are dealing with wood lanes...
Yeah.
Or a really dry lanes, this is a ball that you can throw and is not going to hook off the lane.
Oh, yeah. And, like, even for, like, if you're in tournaments with a lot of, like, I find I have to play more outside a lot of guys.
Yep.
Right? So I don't quite get in as far as some other guys. And then when I do try to migrate, when it's my time, I hit the track.
You're hitting their track
right?
and the actual lane track. So you got tons of friction.
Where this ball... would be perfect because coming in, it just would float through.
Yep.
And then it's not spinning off the end, like I said.
You can see that one there. You threw it out in the friction.
Yeah.
And it just gently
rolled
came back.
In. Yeah. And that's the thing is, and we were talking earlier about the Desert Op right now.
Yes.
It's my lower end ball in my bag, and it's got a low flare layout, which keeps it tight and everything. But when it hits that back end, there is sometimes when they're a little too dry and it spins up and then
there's
jumps
still
across.
Yeah. Now, here you are here. Yeah. You can see the same idea with your higher tilt. It's still not really spinning up.
No. It just
And that's beautiful. That's really important. We talk about the desert ops. It's designed for dry lanes.
Yeah.
But it's still a higher differential.
Yeah.
A little lower RG, so it reads earlier.
Yeah.
And flares harder.
Yeah.
For somebody like Cam, who we're seeing here, if you've got a hook point, a defined hook point in the middle of the lane, it's been burnt out. Or for like you said, when you're playing farther out.
Yeah.
You can't move into that track.
Yeah.
You can't have a ball that reads early.
No, because it's either going to roll out.
Yep.
Or just get all squirrely. It's going to start hooking and catch the oil and slide out, and then you get your over-under reaction.
Absolutely. And for somebody like Cam, who has a ton of side rotation, wet-dry is his absolute enemy, because it's going to be super over-under.
Yeah, exactly.
Where this ball, because it doesn't spin up until later, it's getting down lane before it's reading.
Yeah, and you're not worried about it being too dry down lane and the pattern coming to you, because it's not going to spin up early and then leave you the blower nines or the eights or stuff that you get when you get near the end of the pattern.
Or, you know, your rollout tens.
Yeah, exactly.
So this is a very, in my opinion, as a coach, having a high RG ball that has a lower differential, either core or layout, is a very important piece of your tournament bag. And you can see right here, even with Cam, short read, boom. Yeah. Perfect control for when they get dry.
All right, guys, that about wraps it up for another show. If you like what you saw this episode and want to find out more, don't forget to follow us on Facebook at Laneside Reviews or click below.
You can also subscribe to our YouTube channel or click on the box. Or, and if you missed our last video or just want to watch it again, you can click on the other box.
And don't forget, you can pick up any of the jerseys you see in our videos by using this coupon code at logoinfusion.com. So until next time, guys, we'll see you laneside.